Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning in the old cookbook show. Today we're going to do a recipe out of this little cookbook, the Mississippi Cookbook of New Southern Recipes. This was published in 1922 by the Yazoo City Herald, Yazoo City, Mississippi. And I want to do a recipe out of it that we're going to come back to again and again and again over the next little while. There's a group of pies that you see in cookbooks in the southern United States that go by a couple of different names, and there's a bunch of different variations in the recipe. The one we're going to do out of this cookbook today is called cheese pie. So, if you're from the South, as you're watching me make this, you're going to probably be screaming out, "That's a..." And we'll get to that in a moment. So we start out with eggs. I need 3 eggs, 1 whole egg, and then these 2 eggs, I just need the yolks, and I'm going to save the whites for later for a meringue. And this is one of the only recipes I've found for this style of pie that does have meringue. So it's not as common. Meringue is not as common as the pies without. So we're gonna put this in and we're gonna see what happens. Okay, there we go with the eggs. Now, next in is a load of sugar, a little bit of flour, some melted butter, and then we need some milk. We need 3 tablespoons, I believe. Let's check the recipe. Yes, 3 tablespoons of milk. So, got the milk. It's really, everything just gets dumped into the container and mixed up. The last thing that it asks for is a flavoring, and you can use either lemon or vanilla, one or the other, and you get the choice. I happen to have a lemon today, so I am going to do lemon. Okay, so. Now the recipe doesn't give an amount of lemon or vanilla. It just says flavor with lemon or vanilla or lemon. So I'm going to use the juice of a whole lemon because I really like lemon flavoring. Don't know if it's too much. It might be too much. Who knows? We're gonna put that in and now we'll just beat all of that together. One of the first thoughts I had when I was reading this recipe was that maybe the lemon is meant to curdle the milk and make it like cheese. But there's only 3 tablespoons of milk. Not enough that's going to give any sort of cheese-like consistency. And you don't have to use lemon. You could use vanilla, and vanilla is not going to cause any curdling. And then I kind of thought, well, maybe because it's a custard, it's kind of like a cheese, and that's where the cheese idea comes into it. Who knows? Lots of different interpretations of how this could go. So I've got a pie shell here. This is a lard crust pie shell. You could use butter. It doesn't say which kind to use, just that it's supposed to be cooked inside a pie. So I'm going to get all of this in here. Again, no baking instructions, other than bake it till it's brown. So I'm gonna put it into the oven. I've got a baking tray in the oven already, ready to go. So in case this bakes over, which I don't think it will, I use the smallest pie tin that I own, and I think it's still too big. I know that in earlier times, pies were smaller. So into the oven, and we'll see what happens. Looks like the pie is almost done, so it's probably time to start making the meringue. In the copper bowl, I have the egg whites, and it tells me to put in some sugar and beat them to a nice volume. Okay, three things about this copper bowl. First thing about this copper bowl, I know that you can take a wet tea towel, make a ring, put the bowl in the middle, and then I wouldn't have to hold the bowl while I was mixing. But then what would I do with this hand? This hand would just be, I don't know, what would I do with it? I don't mind holding the bowl. Second thing, yes, a bare copper bowl is food safe for whipping egg whites. I get that question all the time. Yes, if you buy copper pots, they're tinned on the inside so that acidic foods that you're cooking don't leach out too much copper. Copper in of itself in moderate amounts isn't harmful to you. In fact, you do need copper in your diet. But in excessive amounts, say you're making a tomato sauce in a copper pot, if it wasn't tinned, you'd get excessive amounts of copper. Some copper pots, though, are not tinned on the inside. They're not lined on the inside. And those are used for making candy and jam because the temperatures that you need for making those two things is higher than the melting point of the tin on the inside. In which case, if you tried to make candy in a tin-lined copper pot, you're going to get a whole load of tin in your candy. So those copper pots aren't lined, but most copper pots are lined. This copper bowl doesn't need to be lined because it's not dangerous. And the third thing, if you don't have a copper bowl, a pinch of cream of tartar will sort of replicate this foam structure. Not perfectly. I used to use that trick all the time because I didn't have that copper bowl. Now that I have that copper bowl, I'm never parting with it. So I think the pie is ready to come out. And I'll pop this temperature up to broil. And on goes the egg. There was only two egg whites, so you're not going to get a giant mound of meringue. You could pipe the meringue on and get, you know, really nice little rosettes of meringue with the little curls on top so that it's, you know, when it browns, it looks really perfect. But there really isn't a lot of meringue here to work with. So I'm going to pop this in the oven and we're going to brown it. And then we'll let it cool off and we'll do a tasting. Yes, chicken, it does look delicious. Okay.
Hi, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hi, friends.
Chicken was just doing the rounds here.
You have a lot to say?
He had a lot, had a lot to say.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Okay. This is...
Nice meringue.
Meringue is pretty good, yeah. I mean, there were only two egg whites, so you didn't get a good pile of meringue, but...
I'm already in there, Glen. It's too late. I wasn't waiting. Wasn't even waiting. Oh, it's gone.
Mm-hmm.
That's a pretty nice little pie.
Yeah.
It has, it's a lovely, it's not creamy. It's like, it's a bit like a lemon meringue.
A bit like a lemon meringue, but it's not that gelatiny
no.
kind of lemon structure in the middle.
It's not quite creamy.
No. So this is related. It's called a cheese pie.
But I'm not getting any cheese.
There's no cheese. But it's related to that group of pies in the American South called chess pie.
Okay, that makes sense.
Most often chess pie. This one has flour instead of corn, cornmeal.
It's actually got it's not quite as... has less formal texture than
yes.
a chess pie than
yeah.
I'm used to, that I would associate with a chess pie.
And so it's related to chess pie and...
You said it's cheese pie.
But it's called cheese pie.
Sorry, I'm just...
It's cheese pie, it's related to chess
okay.
pie. And when, so this is 1922, Mississippi. This is 1912, Tennessee. 1912, Tennessee. And in the Tennessee cookbook, there's two pies called chess cake and old-fashioned chess cake. But they're pies, and they're essentially this.
Okay.
So,
there's I'm curious this... to how the old-fashioned is different than the...
They both use sherry.
Mm.
And instead of lemon, so this one you could have used lemon or
I should leave
vanilla.
Some for you.
You should leave some for me. Or vanilla, I guess, depending on which one you had or which one you could afford. Most chess pies in these old cookbooks that I found use lemon. The two in this book use sherry and orange.
Okay.
And so, I mean, this is a pie that I think evolved in a bunch of different places, but all kind of have the same name, or a similar name, but they're different pies.
So someone learned how to make it or saw it somewhere
and then
made the version that they could in their space with what they had.
And the name sort of went, and some people have posited that chess cake is cheesecake, but someone didn't know how to make cheesecake. They just sort of made as best they could. So there's a million ways to make chess cake. And sometimes you can call it cheesecake. Sorry, chess pie. Sometimes you call it cheese pie. Sometimes you call it chess cake pie. I just call it really good.
Mm-hmm.
I'll eat that.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.